Hello friends, welcome back to Best Way to Study. In this video, we are going to see the most important questions for AP Intermediate First Year Civics exam. Okay, now let's begin our video. Coming to the most important questions for Civics for AP Board. Now let's see chapter wise. Okay, so coming to Introduction to Political Science, 2 marks in 2 marks questions. Who is Aristotle is very important question, and write about modern definitions of political science, very important question, and how does political science teach the quality of good citizenship. These are all from Introduction to Political Science, and these are two marks important questions. Okay, now let's see what are the important questions for 10 marks. Okay, in Introduction to Political Science, define political science, what is the scope of the political science, and what is the significance of the political science. These three questions are very much important. Okay, so coming to the next chapter, which is state, coming to 2 marks questions, they'll ask you what are the organs of government and what is state, what is meant by state, and they'll also ask you in 5 marks questions, define state and what are the essential elements of state. Okay, and they may also ask you to differentiate between state and society. Okay, so coming to next chapter, nationalism, coming to 2 marks, they'll ask you what are the merits and demerits of nationalism. This is nothing but what are the advantages and disadvantages of nationalism. Okay, so 5 marks answers also will come from this chapter, that is nationalism chapter. Coming to 5 marks questions, you should prepare what are the differences between nation and nationality. Okay, and write a short notes of Indian national state. Okay, and they'll also ask you, is India a national state? Coming to 10 marks, there is only one most important question, that is what are the essential elements of nationality. Okay, please prepare these questions, they are very important. So coming to the next chapter, law. Okay, coming to law, 2 marks questions are also very important. They'll ask you questions such as what is public law, what is the definition of law, and what is origin of law, what is rule of law. Please tell me what are the features of law. These are very short questions. Okay, they come for 2 marks. Coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you what is the law and explain the sources of law. Okay, these two questions are very common, and they may also ask you what are the different kinds of law. Okay, so coming to next chapter, liberty and equality, please concentrate on 2 marks and 5 marks questions. Coming to 2 marks, you need to concentrate on what is equality, what is liberty, what is importance of economic equality. These three are very important questions. Coming to 5 marks from liberty and equality chapter, you need to concentrate on what is meant by equality and what are the different forms of equality. Okay, and they'll also ask you what is the relationship between law and liberty and explain the different kinds of liberty. These are most repeating questions. Okay, so coming to next chapter, rights and responsibilities, this is also one of the most important chapter. From this chapter, you will be getting 2 marks questions, 5 marks questions, as well as 10 marks questions also. So coming to this particular rights and responsibilities chapter, first let's see what are the important 10 marks question. Okay, coming to 10 marks, they'll ask you what are rights. You need to define it, what are rights, and they'll also ask you describe the civil and political rights. Okay, this is one of the most commonly repeated question. Okay, and coming to 5 marks, they'll ask you explain the safeguard of rights and what are the features of rights, and please write an essay on human rights. Okay, these kind of questions are very important. Coming to 2 marks from the same chapter, you need to concentrate on objective of human rights, classification of the human rights, features of the human rights, and what are rights. Okay, coming to a small tip which I would like to give you. first learn what is the definition of rights. Okay, so whatever answer or whatever question they may ask you related to rights, first if you write this definition, you'll be getting good marks. Okay, because this like whatever question they may ask you, they'll surely ask about rights. So you must define what are rights. So make sure you learn the definition of rights. At least you should learn 2 to 3 lines of the definition of rights. Okay, so now let's see from the chapter justice. From this particular chapter, only 5 marks and 2 marks questions will be asked, no 10 marks questions will be asked. So coming to 2 marks important, please concentrate on define justice. What are the sources of justice? What is social justice? Okay, coming to 5 marks, you need to concentrate on what are the different types of justice. Same tip for this chapter also, please learn what is the definition of justice. Okay, so that whatever question they may ask you related to justice, you can give that definition. Okay, so coming to the next chapter, citizenship, they are going to ask you 2 marks and 5 marks questions. Coming to 5 marks questions, concentrate on what is significance of citizenship, what is citizenship, and difference between single citizenship and dual citizenship. These are important for 2 marks. Coming to 5 marks questions, you need to concentrate on define the methods of acquiring citizenship. What are the different qualities of a good citizenship, and what are the hindrances? Hindrances is nothing but obstacles. Okay, what are the hindrances of good citizenship? These are very important 5 marks questions from citizenship. Okay, so now let's see from the next chapter, which is democracy. Okay, so coming to democracy, this is one of the most important chapter. Coming to democracy, you will be asked 2 marks question, 5 marks question, as well as 10 marks question. So please concentrate and please make sure you study this chapter for sure. Okay, so coming to 2 marks important questions from democracy, you need to concentrate on what is the root word of democracy, what is direct democracy, what are the features of democracy. Learn how to define democracy. Okay, the definition of democracy is very important. Okay, so coming to 5 marks questions, they'll ask you what are the importance of democracy and what is the features of democracy. Okay, and coming to 10 marks, they'll ask you what are the merits and demerits of democracy. Merits and demerits are nothing but what are the advantages and disadvantages of democracy. Okay, so coming to next chapter, which is secularism. Okay, coming to secularism, you need to concentrate on 5 marks, because only 5 marks questions will be asked from this particular chapter. So coming to secularism, you need to concentrate on what is secularism, explain the concepts of secularism, and they'll also ask you what are the different features of secularism. Okay, these are very important for 5 marks. So coming to next chapter called constitution, coming to constitution, you need to concentrate on both 2 marks questions and 5 marks questions. 10 marks questions will not be asked from this particular chapter, but they are going to ask you 2 marks and 5 marks important questions. Okay, so coming to constitution, coming to 2 marks important questions, concentrate on what is unwritten constitution, what is written constitution, what is difference between unwritten and written constitution, what is constitution. All these questions will be frequently asked. Okay, so coming to 5 marks questions from important questions from constitution, please concentrate on what is constitution and what are the features of constitution. Okay, so make sure you learn the definition of constitution, it's very important, and they'll also ask you what are the merits and demerits of written constitution and what are the merits and demerits of unwritten constitution. Okay, this is very important question, students. So coming to the next chapter, but last but not least, this chapter is very much important. The chapter name is government. From this chapter, you're going to get 2 marks questions, 5 marks questions, as well as 10 marks questions. So please make sure you concentrate more on this particular chapter also. Okay, so coming to 2 marks important questions, please concentrate on what is individual responsibility, what is judicial review, what is division of power, what is single citizenship, what is Aristotle's classification of government, what is individual responsibility for government and all. Okay, these are for 2 marks. Coming to 5 marks, important questions from government chapter. You need to concentrate on distinguish unitary and federation government. What are the differences between parliamentary and presidential government? Last but not least, write about the theory of separation of power. This is very important 5 marks questions. Okay, now let's see what are the most important 10 marks question for this particular chapter. Okay, explain the merits and demerits of unitary government. Very important. Explain the merits and demerits of federation of government. Explain the merits and demerits of parliamentary government and presidential government. Students, please make sure you study all these important questions, because from every chapter I'm hardly giving you some 10 questions. If you learn these questions, you are really going to pass in the exam. And these are some of the questions which you cannot miss at all. They are very important. Now let's see what are the tips I can give you for you to easily pass in the exam. So for every chapter, as I said, make sure you learn the basic definition. For example, if it is for government, you should learn what is the definition of government. If it is for state, you should learn what is the definition of state. So for every chapter, make sure you learn the definition of the chapter name and important questions, whatever I told you, make sure you read them and concentrate on highlighting the side headings with the black or blue pen. Okay, and after each and every answer, make sure you draw 2 lines. Okay, even line borders you need to draw in the question, in the answer sheet. Okay, so that it will give you a good it gives you a very good impression to the examiner. Okay, and you should make sure you should manage your time well, because the answers will be lengthy. So make sure you are not running out of the time and do well in your exam. If you have any doubts, if you have any queries, or if you wanted me to ask anything related to the subject, do let me know in the comment section below. And don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, like and share this video with all your friends, because I'm going to do more and more important questions videos for all your subjects. So don't forget to subscribe, hit the bell icon, like, share and comment. Okay, so all the best for your exam. Don't panic, relax, study hard, work hard, because if you work hard you can succeed. Okay, so yeah, thank you so much for watching this video. Don't forget to share and subscribe, and all the best. Thanks for watching.